everyone, and welcome back to my channel. You know guys, I've suddenly realized that lately I'm working only on Monster High and Barbie dolls. I don't know, before I remember, I used to experiment also like on different kinds of dolls. I remember we had a lot of fun here torturing the Bratz doll, if you remember that video. Really, that was an epic video here on my channel. Then I also experimented quite a lot with the LOL dolls and with these tiny ones, LOL Surprise. Here they are, you can see them here. And I've also repainted the big LOL doll, the LOL OMG, when it just came out. So, you know, I think I would love to continue experimenting with different kinds of dolls sometimes. And that's why today I have bought this beautiful, or not that beautiful, I don't know yet, Snapstar doll. I can tell you honestly, I have zero personal opinion about this Snapstar doll collection, as well as zero knowledge about it. I know just I see them really super often nowadays, and in the online store where I've bought it, it said that this is a toy of the year of 2019 or something like this. So I'm really curious to take a closer look at this doll because I've never seen them in real life. Of course, also due to the pandemic, I don't go shopping when it's not 100% necessary. I buy all my dolls online. So this is actually the first time I see this doll in person, the first time I hold her in my hands, well, the box I hold in my hands. So now I think we're going to unbox this doll, we're going to see what is inside, and of course we're going to repaint this doll, we're going to destroy it all completely, and we're going to make our own star out of this doll. And I have actually already prepared the concept for this makeover, and as you could see it of course already from the thumbnail, we're going to turn this Snapstar girl into Insta Granny. Because you know, there are too many influencers nowadays, like everybody is in Snapstar or some Insta Diva or whatever. But for me personally, the most inspiring women I see on social medias are the Insta Grannies, like they call them. So it's ladies who are for sure 80 plus, I would even say like 90 plus, or at least 85 plus. They're amazing, they're so bright, they're so fun, and you know, for me, like I'm 36 years old, of course I'm thinking about aging and about my future, and when I see these beautiful ladies, I feel like, okay, my future is bright, I have still all chances to have fun for the next, I don't know, 50 or 60 years, if I'm lucky enough to live that long. Because nowadays, you know, we are worried so much about aging, but half of the people don't even get a chance to age. So anyway, it's quite serious topic to talk about, and this is an entertaining video. So today we're going to turn this Snapstar girl into Insta Granny. I will not use anyone like specifically as a reference, but of course I have Betty Winkle in my heart and Iris Apfel and some other ladies, so I think you would be able to see different, I don't know, like features, elements of style of these ladies presented, created in this doll. So, but first of all, we're going to have fun with this big set. I haven't purposely bought a big set. So, let's unbox it, let's have fun with it. Yeah, and if you're the first time on my channel, please don't forget to subscribe. Hit the bell to get notified about my new doll repaint videos. I'm trying, I'm really trying guys to upload every week Friday, but lately you can see it, I'm going all the time for bigger projects. And it's just almost impossible to follow up because making a video, pictures, and so far it takes for sure 3 days. And if you're uploading a doll per week, it means you have just 4 days to make the entire doll. This is impossible with my recent projects. Like if you take a look at my dolls that I've released, let's say this summer, starting from May, June, they're all quite big and complicated projects. So hit the bell button to get notified about my new projects, because yeah, it's not always that regular like it used to be before every week Friday, but you know, if I'm skipping a Friday, it's always just for good. It means I'm preparing something really big. Well, and now let's start working. I'm really looking forward to see what is inside, because there are some things. Let's check it out. Here you can see all the dolls from this collection. There are 6 of them. This is how our set supposed to look assembled. So we have a doll, we have a chair, we have some 2 spotlights. And yes, this is approximately the only thing that I know about this line. I've read about it when it was released. You can download a special app, then you can load pictures of your doll into this app, and then you will be able to style this doll in some way in this app, and then you can post it also there in the same app, because it likes some sort of a, I don't know, Snapchat for dolls or something like this. So let's open the box and let's take a closer look at everything. So here I see already immediately the green screen. I guess this is what it is. But yeah, I will not assemble this green screen right now. Just, yeah, I will just admit that this is a regular carton. It's not this synthetic material that they regularly use for making photoshoot backgrounds. This is a regular green carton. Yeah, and here we can see more instructions. You can see everything that is in the set, and we can see how to style the doll. And here I see very good news for myself. It looks like this doll wears a wig. It's not her real hair, so it's ideal. It's absolutely perfect. For once, I don't have to pluck this hair from the inside of the head. Here we see how to assemble the spotlights. Okay, and here is how to assemble the background. Okay, where is my doll? I want to see the doll already, finally. Yeah, it's difficult to get her out. Okay, let's probably start step by step. Yay, our spotlight have been assembled, and here is a button. Here you need to remove the plastic first. Pardon. Voila. And then put this thing back. And yay, our spotlight works. Yeah, here is our spotlight. Okay, now we can assemble the second spotlight in exactly the same way. So here we've got our 2 spotlights. Here we go, both of them working, everything is okay. And here I also have a stand for my doll. And then here I have a couple of color filters. There for some, it's for the spotlights, you see, like this you can make it. So like this we have white light, then with this red filter we have a red light, then we have here also blue filter for blue light, and the orange filter, yeah, it will make everything a little bit warmer. So, and here is our doll. Yeah, she's pretty cute, but I can tell that she gives me kind of strong Bratz vibes. I've even googled who is the maker of this doll, if it's not the same company who is making Bratz dolls, but no, it's another maker. But anyway, you know, these body proportions, they give me kind of Bratz feelings. But anyway, I think she looks quite cute. All in all, her proportions are still a little bit healthier than the Bratz proportions. Of course, she also has this very big head and a tiny body, very tiny torso. But anyway, I don't know, I don't hate this doll as much as I hate Brad's dolls, honestly. So, as we could see it already, she has a wig. Yes, here is a hole to put the wig on. Yeah, the hair quality is very, very, very average. I would even say it's cheap hair. Barbie dolls normally have better hair quality, and Monster High dolls, they also normally have better hair. And this is really this kind of hair you normally get on the cheapest styling doll heads that look like sponge. So no, it's not good hair. Yeah, the outfit is also not my favorite. The shoes I really like. Yes, they're really cute. So here is the complete set unboxed. And you know, I think it's actually quite a fun idea. I really love the spotlights. I really love the idea of organizing a photo shoot for your dolls, because it's really a cool way of playing with dolls, like even adults enjoying photographing their dolls. Yeah, it's like a way of playing with them. You know already, I hate Brad's dolls, but this doll I think is better than Brad's. She's prettier than Brad's. The proportions are still, you know, like not the healthiest, but at least she has feet. It's already a huge thing, because I almost got a heart attack when I realized that Brad's dolls have just shoes attached to their legs. Unbelievable. So, and all in all, yeah, it's okay. It's okay. It's a little bit like China style, but it's okay. The wig is turning like this. There is no really good fixation of the wig, so you can wear it. You see, it's turning too easy. Yeah, because it's just a round hole and the spin is also round. So, of course, it's all turning in different directions. You see, immediately trying to like fix her hair a little bit, and this wig is turned. Look, like, oh, what do you have here? Some hair is a little bit loose, like, oops. 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 I don't know. Okay, what are we gonna do with you? First of all, we're going to undress her, of course. Then we're going to remove all the shoes and accessories. And then we're going to think about what we're gonna do with her eyes, because she has these inserted eyes. We're going to think about it in a second. So, let's start the distraction and we will decide what we're gonna do while we're busy. But actually, before undressing her, I want first to make a couple of pictures and to use their app to style the doll, I don't know, to see all the features of it, and then we'll be able to compare their styling and my styling in the end of this video. It will be like Poppin versus the Snapstar app or something like this. So here you can see me playing with it. I was getting some error messages all the time, and on my phone this app just refused working. The screen stayed black all the time, so it works on my iPad but still with error messages. So, and here you can see what we've got. You see that this doll's body is very pale, and it's also very thin, I mean her legs, and that's why this green screen, it's very green, it's very intense, and that's why it's made the body look greenish on the pictures, because of the reflection from the green screen. And that's why it looks so clumsy when we change the background. There are actually not that many styling options, but anyway, this is actually quite fun, and I can tell you honestly, I would enjoy it as a kid. So, this is the doll edited with their app, and now let's see what I can do without the app, just with my hands. She has actually a very nice, fully articulated body. You can see everything is perfectly movable. the body, the hands, the feet, super. It's kind of like Barbie made to move, absolutely nice. And now let's remove all this paint from her face and her head using pure acetone. And then we'll take a closer look at her eyes. You know guys, on one hand I'm extremely tempted to make a pair of new eyes for her. But you know, for this you need special silicone molds. I've ordered a couple of weeks ago a set of eye molds from AliExpress, but they haven't arrived yet, unfortunately. And who knows how long it will take because of the pandemic. So I think I will keep her original eyes today. And then later, when I receive the molds from China, we will test them completely and we will make dolls with new handmade eyes. And today, I don't know, I just think I'm going to mess up completely if I try to make her eyes without using the eye molds. So, I've protected the eyes with masking tape and now I can seal it with a couple of layers of Mr. Super Clear sealant. It will make the surface matte and I will be able to draw on it with watercolor pencils. And I'm starting with sketching the eyelids, the eyebrows and the main wrinkles. These doll's eyes look very wide open, like even originally, even on the original doll with the original makeup, like if she was surprised or scared. And I think I will go for a face and in a kiss today, something like on these Betty Winkles pictures. I think it would look cute and playful and it would also explain the wide open eyes. Then I take soft pastels and I draw natural shadows. And on top of it, I apply a layer of cold pink pastels. It will reduce the orange subtone of the brown shadows. And now let's draw all the wrinkles more detailed. I want to give my superstar lady a very bright makeup, because who said that you cannot wear bright makeup after a certain age? So I will give her a very bright eye makeup, something in pink colors, and as well as very bright pink lipstick. And after this, I add highlights. So, I think we're done with the face for now. You can see clearly the difference between the face and the body. And I guess we have no other option but to blush her body as well. So, let's see how Mr. Super Clear will work on the surface. So, first of all, I'm going to sand the body really nicely with nail buffers to make the surface a little bit grainy. And like this, the sealant and the pastels, they're going to stick to the surface better. After this, I cover it with a couple of layers of the sealant. And then I blush it with the same soft pastels like we've just used on her face. After this, we can move on to her hair, and I'm gonna use this grayish acrylic yarn. I think it will give me really pretty light gray hair color, not a dirty gray, you know, but really pretty one. So now let's turn this yarn into hair. So, and I begin like always with cutting the yarn into shorter pieces. Then I attach the short pieces to barbecue sticks. And then I make the yarn loose. Normally after this, I supposed to brush it and make it straight with my hair straightener. But today I think we will use this yarn like it is, with all these curls, because I think it will give quite an interesting effect in the end. So now I'm going to cut the yarn off the stick and I will glue it to the doll's head using white tacky glue. So, I've let the glue dry completely and I can tell you it already looks quite fun. But now I'm still going to cut her hair and I'm going to make the curls a little bit fluffier and kind of more natural looking. And guys, this is my cute and playful hairstyle. I can tell I really love these curls. They look really super natural. And now I still want to decorate her hairstyle with this golden fabric. And like this, we're almost done with her face and with her body. Oh no, wait, I completely forgot that her eyes are still covered with the tape. I don't know, I've kind of got used to it already. It kind of looks normal to me that her eyes look like this. But anyway, let's now remove the protection. Attach the false lashes, because you know, a real fashionista can wear falsies even after she celebrated her 90th birthday. If she feels like this, of course. And then after this, we will add a touch of glossy varnish to her lips. So now we can finally move on to the outfit part of this video. And today I've asked my mom to make a kind of disco girl costume. Some golden leggings and golden bomber and some sort of a, I don't know, swimming costume that people used to wear above the leggings. Do you remember, by the way, it was such a trend? I think we should expect it to come back soon. Prepare, guys. So, and you can see now my mom working on the outfit. She starts with making a pair of golden leggings, then comes a tiny pink swimsuit, and in the end she's making a golden jacket. So So, and this is what I've got, exactly like I've imagined it. This time the jacket is actually the main star of the collection. And by the way, this is not just a golden shine. It's actually real holo. Wait, I will put the lights off again, like Christine the Holo Queen teaches us. And we will be able to see the rainbows. Yeah, look, this is super cool. You can see it clearly now. Oh my god, holo and these rainbows. It's so pretty, really mesmerizing. So guys, and now we still need to make a couple of accessories to complete the look. And I'm going to start with a pair of glasses that I will make, of course, out of my favorite Warbler thermoplastic. So first of all, I'm creating a basic shape. Then I'm going to attach this light orange light filters to the glasses to make like the glass of the glasses. Then I decorate them with rhinestones. And the rest of the glasses I'm covering with black acrylics. So here are the glasses. Yeah, they look very stylish, I think. And now let's make a pair of shoes for my lady. And I've made actually a very interesting discovery earlier. You know, this girl, the Snapstar doll, she can wear Barbie shoes. Really, check it out. It all fits just perfectly. And you know, since I've made this beautiful discovery, I think I will not just let the opportunity go and I will use one of these pairs of Barbie shoes. Why do I have them otherwise already for years? And I really love these white shoes borrowed from some Barbie fashionista. So let's customize them. I think they would make our lady even more a superstar. And first of all, I will slightly sand them with nail buffers, and then I will cover them with a couple of layers of black acrylics. The top I will decorate with rhinestones as well. I will add a touch of golden paint in the end. After this, I think I'm done with the details, and now I can finally put everything together, and then we'll take a look at the end result of my work today. So here is my super stylish Insta grandma, and now it's finally time to decide who have become a winner of this competition, Poppin versus Snapstar app. Do you remember? We've decided to make a competition like this in the beginning of this video. So now it's up to you. Please vote in the comments under this video. But I can tell you one thing for sure. Oh my god, guys. She's such a hot thing, this Instagramma. I can't imagine her being the first beauty somewhere in the 70s and even in the 80s. Strangely enough, I really love how the very bright blue eyes go together with the visible signs of aging on her face. It's like she's of course an older lady, but you can perfectly see how young she is in her soul. I was really worried that the eyes would look too alien on her face, but in fact they make her even more cute and touching, I don't know, in some way. The hairstyle looks gorgeous today, and the jacket is, like I said, the main star of the party. So I'm very happy with the first experiment on the Snapstar doll, and I think we might play with them some more in the future. If you want to watch it, of course, I don't know, it's all up to you again. So tell me please, what do you think about the Snapstar dolls, and if you want to see me repainting more of them in the future. And if you have any good ideas for the future Snapstar makeovers, please don't hesitate to leave them in the comments under this video as well. And this doll is available for sale on eBay right now. It will be there for 3 days like always, so if you're interested, please check the link in the description box under this video. So guys, and that was my doll transformation of the week. I really hope you enjoyed it today. And if so, please don't forget to support my art here on YouTube with your likes. Of course, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button, and I will see you already very soon in my new doll repaint video. Love you guys. Bye.